Welcome to another video of the RShiny dashboard series. In the previous video, we have built a dashboard with interactive bar chart using Render and Reactive. So if I run the dashboard, this is how it's going to be looking like. I have a choose sales representative drop-down list here. I can choose the sales representative and the chart will change accordingly. And now in the background, we have ggplot and we are showing sales information by quarter for each of the sales representative. Now, obviously, when we build this app, what we did is we created this list manually. Now, in real life scenario, typing this manually can cause a lot of errors and we can have some inputs that may not align with the data and it will not end up showing on the dashboard. And so to ensure that this populates dynamically directly from the data, what we'll be doing now in this video is that we're going to dynamically update the select input of that particular drop down that we just saw. So let us see the app now once again before we make any edits. So now what we're going to do is, instead of having this manually typed, we are going to produce it dynamically. First, let me just give you a preview of what that whole code looks like in case you're new to this video. We begin by setting the directory where the data is present. Then we'll load the three libraries, Shiny, dplyr, and ggplot2. Then we have a function server, and then we have another function UI. So this is where your data manipulations get done, and this is where you'll display what manipulations you have done, and the user gets to interact with this particular portion. So everything heavy happens in this particular portion. What we are doing is we are importing the data, then we are putting the data into a reactive frame here, where any input changes by the user will come here and it will reproduce the data. Then it will produce that same data that got manipulated here in this place and display the chart dynamically. Now, the only additional stage that we are adding is we are trying to get this list dynamically versus typing it manually. So for that, we're going to begin by getting the list of select inputs dynamically. To begin with, what I'm going to do is I'm going to use observe to create our list for the select input dynamically. I'm going to begin by introducing a frame called as observe. We can call it a method. And then I'm going to open by round bracket and then also curly bracket and press enter. Now, what we're going to do is you want to use a function, a method called as update select input, and it automatically comes in. And as you can see, it has three different arguments. It has the session, select sales representative. The choices are going to be coming from the data set directly. So we'll begin by inputting all the three arguments, that is the session, comma, I'm going to say the select input that we're going to use, right? So this is the one that we'll be using. So I'm just going to use this as is. And then the third argument is going to be choices. I'm going to say is equal to, and it's going to be coming from the sales data that's here, and all the values that are present in sales rep. Now, once we have this setup, obviously we need to transfer what is available here to the list that is available down below here, right? Now, if I just remove this and run the code, I'm just going to save it and run it. It's going to be throwing an error saying choices is missing. So obviously there is something that we need to do such that the list that got created here transfers to this particular place where the select input is available. So to do that, we have something called as the names, right? So if I say comma and say names, it automatically brings whatever is available here to this place dynamically, which means what will happen now is that instead of us typing those names that we saw here, this list, now observe will get all of these names that are available within the sales representative dynamically to this particular drop down. And so now if I save this and run the app, you'll see instead of us typing it manually, it's now populating dynamically. This is how you create a drop down list dynamically using the observe method and obviously the update select input function. Now, also if you notice, if I expand this window, you'll see the chart is going to go haywire. and obviously it does not look professional. So in the next video, we'll attempt to create the same dashboard into another layout and have it professionally looking so that the user gets a better experience while dealing with this particular app. Thank you for watching this video, guys. If you like this tip, please hit the thumbs up button and please don't forget to hit the subscribe button.